All right, so here checking in with Jeremy McGrath at former, is it JNA Muffler?
It's, yeah, McGrath Auto and Muffler.
McGrath Auto and Muffler, and currently the McGrath side-by-side
parking spot. Shop. It's a side-by-side parking lot.
The former home of Swapmoto Live.
That's right. And the start. This is the start enough. Of Swapmoto Live around here.
Never thank you enough for the start that you gave us.
Oh, dude, no worries. This is awesome. I was telling, you know who was over here today? Phil Lawrence.
Factory Phil was here.
So we were talking about all that, and I'm like, oh, yeah, Swapmoto was in here. He had offices and whatever. And he's like, really? I remember your mom in here. This is your mom's office. You know, that was years ago. So that was kind of fun.
Dude, I just remember when, you know, we started with you at the truck race shop.
Yeah, right.
In Elsinore.
Yeah, right.
And you're like, hey, I'm selling the building. And I was like, hey, thank you. And you're like, no, you're coming with. And you brought us here to show us everything. And I was like, I just couldn't see the vision. There was so much stuff in here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, this is my dad's former auto shop and muffler shop for, what, 40 years?
Yeah.
So when I first showed it to you, boy, this thing was filled with stuff.
Dude.
I mean, my dad just walked. He's like, I'm retired.
I'm done.
And I was like, what do you do at your shop? He goes, I don't know. And I was like, well, I need a spot. I'll rent it from you or whatever. And he's like, okay.
Yeah.
But at that point, he meant that I had to clean it, too.
Yeah. Dude, so, I'll say Carl Scanlon's a hero, dude. Came in here with all that heavy equipment and filled those sea containers.
Oh, yeah. We had some containers. Remember we lifted the containers up with the forks?
Yeah.
Pretty crazy. But, it's looking better now. But, I mean, I got too much stuff. That's how it goes.
Whatever happened to the box of old Playboys and that one Playgirl?
I took them home to my house. I haven't looked at them since, but they were in the milk. Remember they were in the milk crate?
Yeah.
Yeah, my dad had old Playboys, like the whole milk crate was full of them. And I figured, you know, there's probably something historic in here.
Yeah. And, did you ever get the story about the one Playgirl?
The one, no. It's probably still in the box, though. Yeah. Boy, you were looking through the box if you found the Playgirl.
Yeah.
Dang.
Yeah.
I didn't notice that one.
Me and Donnie were checking it out.
That's hilarious.
Oh.
No, I brought it home because I thought, oh, well, you know, someone,
it might be some collectors.
Some old magazines. Mm-hmm. Yeah, somewhere.
So, dude, I saw you riding at Fox Raceway a little while ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, who's that? Man, that guy rides like Jeremy. But I didn't recognize you because you were in that mended gear.
Oh, yeah, right? Yeah.
So talk about the whole mended movement now and Malcolm reinventing the whole brand for himself. Because it used to be that bag. He made this little satchel.
Man purse.
Yeah.
Okay, so everyone knows Malcolm McCassie. He was worked at No Fear for a lot of years. He's the one that built Ethica, and that was his company. Now Malcolm's on to his new brand called Mended. Mm-hmm. He's making moto gear, and he started out with little fun projects. He was doing consulting for a lot of people, right?
Yeah.
Not a lot of people in our world, like Razor, the company Razor Electrics, worked for them. Traxxas RC Cars, like different companies placed with logo placement and stuff like that. So, and then he was continually building his brand, Mended, and we've been talking about it for a long time. Malcolm and I have the same birthday. We've been friends for a long, long time.
Mm-hmm.
He started making gear. The kids started doing it. He got it sort of figured out. And then you guys remember I was Thor for so long, and then I went to Troy Lee, and then Troy Lee sold his company, and Troy really just kind of checked out a little bit on it. Mm-hmm. And I don't race that much or whatever, I just do fun stuff, so I'm still a Troy Lee guy. He's gonna paint my helmets.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Troy are like best friends, so it's like I was just like, you know, hey, I'm going to go help out Malcolm. I want to be part of this new Mended movement. So anyways, that's kind of where it wound up. Have you seen Mended? This stuff's so good. Cool.
Yeah.
Have you ridden in it?
No, I've been bugging Malcolm for a set. Dude. He goes, but it hasn't shown
up yet. It fits so good. Oh, yeah. My God. And it's fun. It's got like different little pockets. Like it's kind of like the everyday man, not a racer. It's racer gear, but with some unique little stuff to it.
Yeah.
And it fits so good. I'm so stoked on it. So, Malcolm's just just getting going. He has that sick AM team, the amateur kids. You see all the social media they do.
There was a bunch of kids wearing Mended at our Mini Monsters East race.
Yeah.
I kept seeing them and taking a picture and sending it to Malcolm. But then after like the 15th kid, I'm, oh, okay, I get the picture. It's well saturated.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He does a good job at that. So, yeah, I'm just Mended guy, Bell helmets, Troy Lee paint, spy goggles.
Yep.
Alpine Star. I just saw Gabrielle. I went to Italy a few weeks ago and rode that two-stroke race at Stefano's track. I'm drawing a blank at the moment. anyways, Gabrielle showed up. Mm-hmm. It was cool. I hadn't seen him in a while. I mean, Gabrielle is like, he's like the Mr. World Traveler. Like the guy never in one spot more than 24 hours.
Hey, isn't it a crack up for as many things as Gabrielle has to do? He is so in tune with everything. The guy sees everything. You know what I mean? Like when I see him, he'll be like, hey, why were you wearing this boot instead of mine on this day? And I'm like, what? How did you know?
Yeah,
right. Saw my Instagram story.
I think Moto is near and dear to his heart. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because I think when he came on board, you know, he had Ricky Johnson, and he was starting to, you know, he was a younger kid back then. He was taking over the company, and then it went to me and a few different guys. And so I think, you know, MotoGP and motocross are his kind of his thing.
Passions.
So yeah, it's cool.
All right, so
we're Majora, about Majora Park.
Majora, that's it. Okay, we're about a week away. Are we going to see you in Mended gear Friday night at Elsinore doing starts?
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to be in
Shot King.
I have a new set of Mended like special gear, 90s edition, coming out for next week.
Nice.
So be on the lookout for that. It's going to be good.
Is it themed after 1-800 Collect gear?
No, it's themed after like Cinesolo gear.
Oh, I saw it.
You saw it?
Yeah, that stuff is sick.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So Malcolm's got a new set for me next week.
Isn't that a jersey that they're going to sell or something at the event? It said Elsinore on the back, like in the old...
Yeah, I think Malcolm, so Malcolm's designer guys and him did a lot of the stuff for Elsinore GP.
Okay, okay.
So you might see some swag there that looks a lot sort of intertwined.
Like the Cinesolo 15.
Right, exactly. Yeah. 94.
Yeah.
93, 94.
Okay, so our buddy Lou is doing the Elsinore GP this year. So obviously you're always down to help your buddies, but this Hole Shot King thing's Friday night.
Yeah, so we're introducing the Hole Shot King, which is Friday night, November 8th, first day of the Elsinore GP. They're having the 4 to 4:30 p.m. GFI reunion race, which is cool. And then 5 to 8, we're bringing in the lights. We got all kinds of killer tents. Vision Canopy just killed it on making like this whole... The Hole Shot King basically is a one-on-one match race from the starting gate. It's basically a drag race. We have a laser system that tells you who wins, green or red, just like drag racing.
No way.
Yeah, it's gonna be really cool. So Risk right there, I have the starting gates right there.
I saw them.
I got the starting gates out. Risk was generous enough to send us some stuff, and we'll be using that stuff next week. My cousin Travis made the metal grates, which is just like the pro guys race on now, which I have no practice on, so I better get started.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's Friday night, Elsinore track, elsinoregp.com is where you can sign up. We're bringing out the lights and yeah, just one-on-one and everyone's included.
No hole shot devices.
No hole shot device.
Dudes are looping out for sure.
I mean, I might loop out.
Huh?
I don't get on the start that much.
We'll call Brian Fullerton at Trevy's up and he come sell rear fenders at this event.
And maybe levers.
Dudes are snapping them off.
Yeah. Oh no. We're probably going to have some guys line up with no rear fenders because they're going to loop out. Yeah.
Yikes. So the race itself, Saturday and Sunday, are you going to line up for any of the events?
Yeah, so I think so. I'm bringing some of my old bikes, you know, like this one here is my aluminum frame 250 two-stroke.
Yeah.
I mean, I just love riding the two-strokes again these days. It's so fun. I have a KX144 I could bring to pro circuit bike. But I have a 90s. I think for the GFI race on Friday, I'm going to bring out my 90. Like serious original team green KX125.
Las Vegas Supercross winning machine.
Yeah, Las Vegas Supercross winner. That's right. I forgot. Yeah. I'm going to bring that bike out for that day. So I don't know. I'm going to bring an assortment of KX weapons. See how it goes. Maybe nice. I'll bring the 500. We'll see.
Yeah. So the track is self-contained within Elsinore MX Park.
Yeah, so, you know, unfortunately, we're not getting to run down Main Street, which Elsinore GP has a lot of history with that.
Mm-hmm.
In this instance, we're going to be doing all the tracks at the Elsinore track combined, right? So mm-hmm. pro track, vet track, and whatever other tracks they have.
The truck track.
The truck track, the Lucas track. Yeah, the former Lucas track. So I think, according to Lou, it's going to be like a 6-7 minute lap time. It should be pretty fun.
Should be gnarly.
How yeah, I mean, there's a lot of stuff.
The GP's
there.
45 minutes? 40 minutes?
Yeah, GP's are 45 minute moto, I think.
Oh, I'm going to have to come out. It's going to be fun.
Yeah, I'll see you there, dude. You're getting on the start line. Let's go. Come on, hole shot king. Let's do it.
Hole shot king. Right on. All right, Jared. Well, hey, thanks for the time, dude. And we'll see you this Friday, Lake Elsinore Motocross Park, 5 o'clock? Did you say 7 o'clock?
5 to 8, November 8th. Elsinore Motocross Park, come join us. Right. Everyone's included. We can race everyone. It's not invite only. It's like, hey, you show up and you want to get on the line with me, that's what we're going to do. So I'll see you there, and I'll see whoever else wants to come out there. But, yeah, 5 to 8 on Friday night, next Friday.
Sounds good. ElsinoreGP.com.
ElsinoreGP.com. Go sign up. Cheers.